Ukraine has taken warfare to the next level, launching the first all-robot ground assault in military history. That's right, no soldiers, just machines blazing a trail into combat. And this isn't just a one-off. In 1,000 days of Russia's invasion, Ukraine has become the world's leader in military robotics, proving that its forces might be outnumbered, but never outsmarted. This is the story of how Ukraine is changing warfare forever, and annihilating Russian troops in the process. What happened in December 2024 near Liptsy, a village in Ukraine's Kharkiv Oblast, is nothing short of monumental. As mentioned, it's the first recorded all-robot assault, and as you'll soon hear, victory anywhere in the world. This unorthodox battle gives us a little glimpse into the future of warfare, a future where strategy and technology eclipse sheer numbers. But we can't discuss this groundbreaking battle without stepping back and looking at everything that led to it. After all, Ukraine didn't arrive at this moment overnight. It's the result of years of ingenuity, adaptation, and sheer necessity. From the earliest days of the invasion, it was clear that Ukraine couldn't match Russia in raw numbers. However, this became abundantly clear after a major Ukrainian counteroffensive failed in the summer of 2023. It was Russia that used robotics to its advantage at the time, forcing Ukrainian forces to realize that a new game changer had appeared. So Ukraine went all in on robotics. The shift was as urgent as it was transformative. By early 2024, Ukraine's defense sector had exploded with innovation, fueled by more than 800 companies, many founded in response to battlefield conditions. The Brave One platform, a state-backed accelerator, tested over 50 robotic ground systems in record time, and Kyiv committed to purchasing hundreds of them. This wasn't just a stopgap, it was a strategy to revolutionize warfare. Ukraine's focus wasn't limited to individual machines. Oleksandr Kamyshin, Ukraine's former Minister of Strategic Industries, declared 2024 as the Year of Land Systems. His goal was to deploy ground robots on the front lines within 12 months. "We count people, and we want our people to be as far from the front line as we can," Kamyshin explained. His words also revealed the core philosophy of Ukraine's robotics push: saving lives while maximizing battlefield impact. The numbers tell us that Ukraine was serious about this goal. By mid-2024, there were over 250 defense startups secretly building unmanned ground vehicles, despite constant threats from Russian bombs. More than 67 models of domestically produced drones were certified, with millions of first-person view or FPV drones and thousands of strike drones produced annually. This unprecedented scale positioned Ukraine as a global leader in robotics, far outpacing rivals in speed and adaptability. Ukraine's efforts didn't stop at machines for direct combat. Anti-drone technology surged as well. Unwave, a firm that had barely any demand for its products in 2023, ramped up production of drone signal jammers to 2,500 units a month by late 2024. These devices became critical tools against Russia's increasingly aggressive aerial drone tactics. Electronic warfare domes, once rare, began appearing on nearly every Ukrainian military vehicle, leveling the playing field in the skies. At this point, Ukraine had achieved what seemed impossible. It wasn't just building robots, it was integrating them into every aspect of warfare, from logistics to direct assaults. This relentless drive for automation culminated in the historic all-robot assault near Liptsy. But this wasn't the first time Ukraine used a robot force to achieve groundbreaking success on the battlefield. In September 2024, the robot named Lyot, which translates to Fury, made history during a smaller-scale operation that served as a proof of concept for larger robot-led strategies. So what did Fury do exactly? Well, this robot cleared a Russian trench in a spectacularly coordinated assault in Volfino, Kursk Oblast, just over the border in western Russia. Much of the success can be attributed to Fury's impressive capabilities, refined through more than 30 trials, so let's briefly overview them. Designed as a robotic mini-tank, Fury is armed with a PKT 7.62mm machine gun that functions as a mobile turret, delivering precise firepower to support combat operations. The robot's precision cameras enable it to engage targets up to 2,624 feet away with deadly accuracy. Besides being remarkably accurate, the Fury is also quite versatile and reliable. In fact, its reliability in real-world conditions set a new benchmark for unmanned ground vehicles. Even in obstructed environments, this robot maintains effective communication at distances of around 2,296 feet. And the best part? This is achieved without breaking the bank, thanks to communication components from commercial drones. The Fury is also exceptionally user-friendly. With prior drone piloting experience, any Ukrainian soldier can quickly master its controls. This mastery was demonstrated in September, when the Fury went into action in Kursk. The robot navigated treacherous terrain, dodged mines, and coordinated with explosive drones and mortar strikes, delivering precise machine gun fire while advancing on enemy positions. It sustained hits from rocket-propelled grenades and FPV drones, but managed to survive, complete its objective, and return to base. It was a picture of efficiency. This success was a pivotal moment. Strategically, the Fury's performance in Volfino highlighted its critical role in an ambitious maneuver. While the main Ukrainian force worked to hold captured territory, the Fury-supported unit aimed to encircle Russian forces. This operation demonstrated how ground robots could not only complement human troops, but also spearhead missions that would be too dangerous or complex for traditional forces. This brings us to the historic event that changed the battlefield as we know it – the world's first all-robot assault. As mentioned, this groundbreaking operation was executed near Lipetsk, with the Ukrainian armed forces relying exclusively on unmanned systems to engage and destroy Russian positions. The Lipetsk operation, a combined arms maneuver, was nothing short of a technological and tactical showcase. The all-robot assault force included heavy multi-rotor unmanned aerial vehicles capable of carrying anti-tank mines or other large explosive charges, FPV drones providing live intelligence and dropping explosives directly on enemy positions, armed ground robots equipped with machine guns and engaging Russian forces head-on, explosive robots designed to function as kamikaze units striking critical enemy positions and barriers, and mine-laying robots disrupting Russian retreats, reinforcements, and supply lines. These units worked together seamlessly to attack, observe, and fortify the battlefield. The operation was orchestrated by Ukraine's famed 13th National Guard Brigade, which holds a 5-mile stretch of the front line near Hlyboka, a key defensive position south of the Ukraine-Russia border. The brigade also released footage of this monumental attack. The footage captured the robots navigating treacherous snow and mud, some firing machine guns mounted on mobile platforms, while others delivered precise explosive payloads. A spokesperson from the brigade described the scale of the operation. "We are talking about dozens of units of robotic and unmanned equipment simultaneously on a small section of the front." The operation was directed from a sophisticated command center miles away from the battlefield. Operators sat in gamer-style chairs and used controllers similar to those of commercial gaming consoles. But their task was no game. They were overseeing a highly coordinated, high-stakes military operation, using multiple screens to track the movements and actions of dozens of unmanned systems in real time. FPV drones used in the attack transmitted high-definition video, allowing precise coordination of ground and aerial units. And what did this HD video show? A decisive victory. That's what. The operation succeeded in its objective of destroying Russian positions. A spokesperson for the brigade confirmed this on air on December 20th. "Ukrainian forces conducted the attack with dozens of UGVs, equipped with machine guns, and successfully destroyed Russian positions during the attack," he proudly declared. And there are plenty of reasons to be proud. The Battle of Lipetsk undoubtedly marked a turning point in the evolution of combat. Mick Ryan, a former Major General in the Australian Army, remarked, "The Battle of Lipetsk is an important step in the transformation of the character of war from a purely human endeavor to something quite different in the 21st century." In other words, this operation was a vision of the future, where machines increasingly take the lead on the battlefield. But what are these machines we're talking about? Unfortunately, the Lipetsk operation didn't provide much detail on the specific models used, but Ukrainian engineers have been developing a wide range of unmanned vehicles and robots for different combat scenarios. Here are some of the key machines that have made significant contributions to Ukraine's robotic warfare capabilities. First, the Ironclad. It stands as one of Ukraine's most ambitious creations. It's a heavily armored unmanned ground vehicle that can storm enemy positions, gather intelligence, and provide fire support. Outfitted with the Shablya M2 combat turret, this robot delivers devastating firepower, while a thermal imaging system ensures it can operate in low visibility conditions. The Ironclad can be controlled remotely, keeping its operators safely out of harm's way. Its speed, up to 12.4 miles per hour, coupled with its ability to withstand small arms fire, makes it a formidable asset on the battlefield. This robot represents Ukraine's determination to create technologies that fight but also protect soldiers who would otherwise be sent into the life-threatening situations. The soldier safety aspect is also what Moroz was designed with in mind. This unmanned ground vehicle aims to keep soldiers safe while providing critical strike and reconnaissance capabilities. However, this robot isn't just about raw firepower, it's about endurance. Moroz can operate for up to 48 hours on a single mission. It can also be controlled from up to 0.87 miles away, keeping its operators far from danger during mission hours. Armed with a 7.62mm machine gun and equipped with a 30x zoom camera and thermal scope, Moroz can engage targets with deadly precision day or night. A similar versatility is seen in the next machine on the list, the D-11 unmanned ground vehicle. But this time, it's all about the robot's role. This vehicle primarily acts as a frontline taxi, transporting ammunition, food, and water to where it's needed the most. However, the D-11 can shift from a transport vehicle to a weaponized system in minutes. This means the same vehicle can provide immediate fire support, perform rescues, and carry essential supplies to soldiers. But what truly sets D-11 apart is its role as a life-saving tool. In a war where medical evacuations are a constant challenge, the D-11 can safely retrieve wounded soldiers from the front lines, sparing human rescuers from the peril of enemy fire. The D-11's ability to navigate rough terrain, covering up to 9 to 12 miles, makes it a true workhorse, tirelessly supporting Ukrainian troops even in the most demanding conditions. Next, the ARC-1 takes this concept of versatility even further. A high-speed, all-terrain robot, the ARC-1 has been engineered to handle everything from delivering supplies to executing kamikaze-style attacks. With a top speed of 28 miles per hour and the ability to navigate steep inclines, the ARC-1 is designed for agility and stealth. Its full-wheel drive and suspension system ensures that it can tackle nearly any terrain, whether in dense forests or across open fields. Operators can control the ARC-1 from up to 12 miles away, sending it deep into enemy territory without exposing themselves to danger. When it's not hauling ammunition or medical supplies, the ARC-1 can be used for more lethal purposes, carrying out surprise attacks on enemy fortifications or equipment. Its combination of mobility, firepower, and range makes it a highly adaptable and valuable ground asset for Ukraine's forces. As the Lipsy operation showed, not all of Ukraine's robotic innovations are grounded. Meet the RATEL-S, a kamikaze drone with a singular focus. Destruction. This high-tech, high-impact drone is equipped with a payload of up to 77 pounds of explosives and is capable of striking both armored and unarmored targets. This robot can also serve as a reconnaissance tool, allowing Ukrainian forces to capture real-time video and photos to enhance their situational awareness. This gives commanders on the ground crucial intelligence as they plan their next move. Beyond the availability of the technology, it's the size of the Russian military that has also encouraged Ukraine to increasingly rely on robotics in its military strategy. You see, Ukraine simply can't maintain a traditional force structure against Russia. The country's forces are frequently facing off against Russian units with the manpower ratio heavily skewed in Russia's favor. In places like the town of Hlyboka, protected by the 13th National Guard Brigade, a mere 2,000 Ukrainian troops managed to hold the line against 6,000 Russians. These figures alone are enough to paint a clear picture of why Ukraine can't afford to rely solely on traditional tactics. And it certainly doesn't help that Russia heavily relies on its troop numbers in its military strategy. This strategy reflects a kind of cannon fodder mentality, where mass assaults and high human losses are accepted as necessary for marginal territorial gains. Of course, this approach is increasingly proving unsustainable, as evidenced by the staggering loss of Russian soldiers in recent months. However, Ukraine is losing troops too. It might not be at the same rate, but Ukraine also didn't start with as many soldiers as Russia. In a rare statement on the matter, Ukraine's President Volodymyr Zelensky revealed that his country lost 43,000 troops since the beginning of the full-scale invasion, almost 50,000 soldiers dead. That's a devastating loss for a country of Ukraine's size. That's why it's safe to assume that the demand for robotic systems also underscores the scale of the manpower shortage facing Ukraine. Despite its technological prowess, the country simply can't match Russia's brute force, but technology, smartly employed, can help level the playing field. This makes Ukraine's adaptation to technology as brilliant as it is somber. But robots aren't intended to replace human soldiers entirely. Instead, they're being used to keep humans out of harm's way. They perform dangerous missions that would otherwise put soldiers at risk, such as reconnaissance, demining, and supply transport. The shift toward robotics also highlights a fundamental difference in how Ukraine and Russia approach warfare. Where Russia relies on sheer numbers and an almost expendable attitude toward human life, Ukraine is doing everything in its power to preserve the lives of its soldiers. But as helpful as robots have been in Ukraine's fight, they aren't without their challenges. One of the primary issues with robotic systems is their inability to hold ground, which is a fundamental aspect of warfare. Historically, infantry has been responsible for occupying trenches, maintaining vigilance, and defending positions over long periods. These duties are taxing, but they are essential to establishing control on the battlefield. Robots, however, simply can't replicate this capability. Even though they can perform attacks and gather intelligence, they're not suited for sustained vigilance required to secure a position. In the case of the 13th National Guard Brigade, there's little evidence that the robots attempted to hold the ground after the all-robot assault in Lipsy. This, of course, raises concerns about the long-term effectiveness of this and similar operations. Another challenge with robotic systems is their inherent vulnerability to breakdowns. Machines, no matter how sophisticated, are still machines. They're prone to failure. This is particularly problematic on the front lines, where harsh conditions and the rigors of battle can lead to frequent malfunctions. Ground robots in particular face issues with maintenance and durability under extreme stress. Even if a robot can function well in the initial stages of an operation, the likelihood of it breaking down in the middle of a mission is a significant risk. The same goes for communications channels, whose disruption can severely diminish the effectiveness of robotic systems. Also, the Ukrainian forces might make it look easy, but integrating robotic systems into military operations is far from a simple task. There's the need to train personnel, ensure adequate support, and establish the systems needed to support robotic operations. Of course, we can't forget about developing the necessary infrastructure for the robots, as well as maintaining them and repairing them in a timely manner. So even though the first all-robot assault is undoubtedly an achievement to be celebrated, don't expect Ukraine to go full Terminator until the end of the war, at least not without ironing out a few more kinks first. For now, the key is to find the right balance, using technology to augment human capabilities, but not relying on it entirely. Ukraine has done so successfully on several occasions. For example, Ukraine's marine drones, known as Sea Babies, have been instrumental in recent naval operations, targeting Russian helicopters and warplanes in Kerch Bay. In a notable attack close to the Crimean Bridge, drones equipped with onboard machine guns successfully struck Russian targets, illustrating the growing precision and lethality of unmanned technologies. Ukraine has also used the so-called Dragon drones to destroy enemy positions like trenches and bunkers, the Honey Badger kamikaze drones to destroy bridges, and robotic drones to drop up to 15 pounds of ammunition or medical supplies to its troops. It seems that Ukraine is assembling its own Avengers, but this time, it's high-tech, unmanned heroes saving the day. And as things currently stand, Ukraine will only expand this hero lineup, with plans to deploy thousands of new ground robots in 2025. But let us ask you this: do you see the unmanned technology like drones and robotic vehicles helping Ukraine turn the tide against Russia? Or is there a limit to how effective machines can be in this brutal conflict? And with the growing dependence on these technologies, what happens if Russia develops countermeasures to neutralize Ukraine's robotic advantage? Share your thoughts in the comment section below. Now go and check out New Ukrainian Drone Mothership Can Turn Any Russian Tank to Dust, or click this other video instead.